On today's video, I'm going to use this board to reveal to you the exact step-by-step process you are going to use to land your prestigious dream job as a nurse working in the United States of America and make more money. You're probably paid pennies on the dollars. Do you want to make more money doing the exact same job in the United States of America? If so, then this is the exact process you're going to use. At step number one, we have education requirement or qualification. To practice in the United States of America as a foreign educated nurse, you must meet educational qualification. You should ensure that your nursing education is equivalent to that of the United States educated nurse. You will require to have a minimum of either bachelor's degrees in nursing, associate's degrees, or diploma from an accredited nursing institution. So that is going to be your first requirement. The second one is going to be your licensure by a nursing body in your country. Nursing is a regulated profession, so you have to be licensed with a licensure body in your country. If you're wondering why there's a demand for nurses in the United States of America, here are some statistics. So according to the Bureau of Labor and Statistics, employment projection year of 2021 to 2031, the registered nursing workforce is expected to grow by a whopping 6% over the next decade. The RN workforce is expected to grow from 3.1 million in 2021 to 3.3 million in 2031, an increase of 195,400 nurses. The Bureau also projects 203,200 nurses opening for RNs each year through 2031, when nurse retirements and workforce exit are factored into the number of the nurses needed in the United States of America. There is an imbalance there. The nursing supply is less while the nursing demand is high. A nursing shortage in the United States has been a long-standing issue in the healthcare. It is driven with so many factors, such as the aging workforce, increased demand for the healthcare services, and the limited capacity of nursing schools to produce an adequate number of graduates. That is our first step. Educational requirements for qualification. Before we unveil our second step right here, if you're new, my name is Marian Tina. I'm a foreign educated nurse practicing in the United States of America. I've been doing that for 4 years right now. So please do subscribe, please do share, please hit the bell notification button to get notified about the videos that we are doing to help international nurses immigrate to the United States of America, and to support the amazing team that work tirelessly to produce this video. Please click the links on the description below and enjoy the amazing offers. Here is Notion. Notion is a single space where you can think, you can write and plan, capture thoughts, manage projects, or even run an entire company and do it exactly the way you want. To get started with Notion today, check the link on the description below. The second step is going to be credential evaluation. Education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. So once you have your educational requirement, you will need to have your documents verified and evaluated. But before you do that, you need to identify the board of nursing that you wish to register for and take the NCLEX exam. Talking of board of nursing, which is the best board of nursing that you can recommend to your fellow nurses? Please write and share in the description below. Right here is a video I personally did on state that I recommend international nurses to use. Remember, you can endorse your license to any other state that you wish. I'm going to also leave the video link on the description box. The reason why I emphasize on the nurse of boarding that you're going to use, not all nursing bodies are favorable for international professional nurses. That's why the video that I've left on the description link are nursing states that I went down, dug deep into their website and saw their requirements. And I came to a conclusion that they are the board of nursing that are more favorable to international nurses. Once you identify the board of nursing, please go into their website and read. I emphasize, read on the requirements to register for international nurses. All states will require you to do your credential evaluation. The evaluation is just to verify your education and your licensure to United States standards. It's like getting a stamp of approval on your international qualification. Every board of nursing has its recommended body to use for the process. All this information is going to be on their website. I recommend to either use Joseph Sinley or CGFNS for your credential evaluation. I'll give you a reason along the way why I recommend those two bodies. Remember, the processing time for credential evaluation varies for each individual and can take up to a year or so. So ensure you follow instruction from your evaluation bodies to avoid unnecessary delay. The reason why I emphasize on that, be very keen, because you don't have control of so many things. One, your credential from nursing school must be sent by this nursing school itself. So you can't send your transcript to the evaluation body by yourself. And also for verification of your licensure body is the one that is going to send your verification papers to the same evaluation body. So you really don't have control over that. Just make sure you follow instructions. You do submit the correct papers and make sure you fill them as needed. You've done the educational requirements and you're sure you're qualified, your education qualified. The next step, you've started your credential evaluation process. Remember, this process can take close to 3 months, 1 month, 9 months. So you don't have control over this. As we are waiting for the credential evaluation report, we are going to go straight ahead to step number 3, which is going to be a very important step, NCLEX preparation. Statistics show that the US educated nurses have a higher pass rate on the NCLEX-RN than their international counterparts. Data shows in 2021, for example, the pass rate for US graduate nurses was 85.2%, while for international nurses, it was 65.7%. This disparity sparks numerous debates, such as, is the NCLEX-RN exam biased against international nurses? Do international nursing programs lack quality compared to the US program? Or are there unfair cultural or language barriers at play? One thing for sure that I know, with proper preparation, international nurses can have a pass rate comparable to those educated in the United States of America. As I'm doing this video, guys, more and more international nurses are taking the NCLEX exam. Just look at this data. In 2022, a total of 35,074 international nurses took NCLEX as first timer, compared to year 2021, where only 18,495 nurses took the NCLEX for the first time. That is almost twice the previous number. So why is NCLEX very important in this process? Why is the NCLEX preparation very important? Because this exam is the gateway to your USRN dreams. This computer adaptive exam accesses your knowledge in 4 key areas. We have the client needs, which is going to be your critical thinking and prioritization, safe and effective care environment, things like infection control and many more. We have the psychosocial integrity and the physiological integrity, guys. So remember, preparing for NCLEX exam is the most important step. Also, there are so many NCLEX preparation guides available online. I'm telling you, be strategic in what you invest on. Sit down, evaluate your study preference, and choose what works for you. Don't fall a victim of buying everything you find on the internet for your NCLEX preparation. Set time for it. NCLEX is one of the easy exams if you prepare well. I had dedicated times that I was reading. I knew my reading style was group discussion and just reading for myself for a little bit. So I invested more on materials that I read rather than what I hear, rather than what I watch, because I liked to read and write and then use that for my group discussion. So that's why I'm telling you, know your reading style, know your study style, know your preference, and invest on the right material. You are here, you prepared for your NCLEX. Good news comes, your credential evaluation is out. Once your credential evaluation is out, you are prepared for your NCLEX and you are ready. What next step are you supposed to do? So that brings us to step number 4. We want to do scheduling and examination. Remember, you can't just wake up in the morning and decide like you're going to do your NCLEX exam. You have to schedule it and you have to take the exam. You will schedule your exam by applying with the body known as Pearson Group. This will be done again once your credential evaluation is complete and you've met the board of nursing that you chose. Requirements of that board of nursing, you've met it. The Pearson Group will look at your application, and once they accept it, they will approve it and they will give you 90 days to schedule your exam at your nearest test center. Not all international countries have NCLEX test center, so it will give you the nearest test center for you to go and take your exam. Personally, I schedule my exam a month from when I got the authority to test. So what they give you is the authority to test. The authority to test is valid for 90 days, so you can schedule your time in between. I took 1 month before I went to do my NCLEX. I wasn't so excited that, oh, my authority to test is out, now let me go and do exam. No, that is preparation for failure. Take 1 month, go through what you've read, be ready, schedule that exam, and go and pass the exam. Remember, success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. If you fail NCLEX, please go ahead and redo it. The next step is going to be taking an English proficiency test. As an international nurse, being proficient in English language is a requirement to practice in the United States of America because that is the primary language. And also, effective communication is not only linked to a better patient outcomes, but also builds confidence between patients and caregivers. There are so many English tests that you can take. The famous one that I took and so many others have taken is the IELTS, and then we have the TOEFL. On the screen right, I'm going to leave the English proficiency test that you can take. Remember, people fail the English proficiency test, and because we speak English, you think you can just walk in and go and do English test and pass. Please do prepare. Preparation is very important in everything that you do. Go to classes if you have to. Talk in front of a mirror to just be prepared on your speaking skills. Go ahead and listen to these audios on YouTube and see, because accent is also a matter, because accent also plays a role. You see the way I'm speaking like this? Trust me, 99% of the time I get like, I can't understand your accent. So it's not that you don't understand English, it's not that you're poor at it, just prepare, because there's so many things involved. We are done with English proficiency test. You've passed your English proficiency test, whichever test you decided to do. You've attained the bands that are allotted to it. We are going to go ahead and go to step number 6. So step number 6 right here is going to be visa screen certification. Visa screen certification is a requirement for immigration purposes. It's a program designed to assess the credentials of a foreign educated healthcare worker. It ensures that the nurse's education matches the minimum qualification eligibility standard set by the US government to work in the United States of America. As I said, this certificate is going to help your employer obtain for you a visa. Remember when I told you when we were doing credential evaluation that I recommend you use CGFNS and Joseph Singley? This is the reason. As at the time of this video, only CGFNS and Justice Sinley are mandated to process visa screen for nurses. That means if you used them for your credential evaluation, you can keep the process of resubmitting your transcript. If it is within a year, they can use the same transcript. Do all this sound overwhelming? Maybe it does. Put in the comments below what you think of all this process, please. Is it something you can do or does it sound difficult? Can you tell me, of all these steps, you're on the step number 6, what is the most challenging and why? I'll be waiting for your answer on the comment section. Okay, we started with a frowny face. We've gone all the way. We are coming here to the last step. And the last step is going to be obtain a visa. Obtain a visa is more detailed, but to practice in the United States as a foreign educated nurse, you have to get a work visa. Most international educated nurses enter the US on a work visa under these three categories. One is going to be the TN visa. The TN visa is only for Mexican and Canadian nurses. Then we have the H-1B temporary work visa. Come work, once your visa expires, you go back. And then we have the employment-based category 3 visa, which is an immigrant visa and which most nurses use because it gives them a visa plus their dependent. To get a work visa, you will need to find an employer based in the United States of America. They have to offer you a job, and in return, they will do your immigration process towards getting the work visa. For your employment, you can use Nursing Recruitment Agency, which is the most common and it's what I recommend, or you can use a US-based hospital employer. I recommend the recruitment agency because they've done this, they've done it always. They have mastered the ins and outs of the immigration process. The US journey is a process that is a long-term investment. Those who know, I've always talked about this. I began my journey in 2016 and I ended up in the US at the end of 2019. So it's going to take you time. You have to be patient. And above all, you have to be cautious. Don't be in a hurry because there are so many dubious recruiters out there. And please be on the lookout not to fall a victim and lose a lot of money in the process of looking for a shortcut. Talking about recruitment agency, as I said, it's what I recommend as an employer. There are so many recruitment agencies. I've Googled, I've done depth detail on nursing agency, and these are my 10 recommended nursing agency. I have done a video, it is right here. Do click it and find the 10 agency that I recommend that will help you with the USRN journey. Also, I'm going to put the link on the description box below. Please do click it and start the USRN journey. It's never too late. If you have the thoughts, start the work.